Hi, my name is Tamika D. Mallory. I'm the co-creator of a new amazing program called Speak Out. This workshop series teaches teens the fundamentals of activism, leadership, and civic engagement. We show our youth that their voices matter, and we instruct them on how to speak out about the issues that are important to them. So I was the talkative girl who was always in trouble. And my mother used to say to me, one of these days, that mouth is going to get you in serious, serious trouble. It may even get you killed. I live to see a time where my mouth is being used for good. And so whatever it is that is inside of you that some people look down on, those are the things that you actually need to work on developing. Because it could be what helps to change your life and the lives of those around you. I want you to take in as much as you can. Because my expectation is that you're going to go back into your school communities, into your homes, into your churches, into Harlem, and pour into people who are around you.
But all of us here have a purpose for being here on Earth. If you don't know what your purpose is yet, the goal is for you to begin to think about that.
Through this program, I introduce participants to some of our nation's greatest leaders, activists, and grassroots organizers. These individuals share their stories and reveal the details of how they have effectively spearheaded powerful movements throughout the world.
The decisions you make today, just like the decisions I made after I was assaulted and recovered from those injuries, those early decisions I made affected my whole life. I'm not trying to put an extreme amount of pressure on you. I just need you to understand that what you do in school right now, it matters. What you do in the streets right now, it matters. What you're doing at home, how you pursue your goals, all of this stuff is gonna set you up for success later.
See, it was lied to as kids. If you come from these communities, if you come from the projects, the Bronx, Brooklyn, Harlem, if you come from the projects, if you listen to the culture, you realize that we idolize the wrong things. We idolize money. We idolize status. We idolize what clothes you have. How many of y'all realize that? Raise your hand if you understand that we idolize the wrong things in this culture. So that, I understood that. And I realized as a rapper, I was feeding into that before I had got incarcerated. Because I had brought into the same ideology. I brought if you have more money than you was real, you could beat somebody or you were tougher, then that made you quote unquote real. So what I did while I was incarcerated, I started to change my perspective. And I said to myself, I understand what's going on. I'm watching these young boys constantly walk in and out of these cells because they're chasing a lot. So if I understand that, I have a responsibility to start telling them the truth.
The program doesn't just stop there. We introduce teens to the fundamentals of how politics work and how resources are dispersed in their local communities. Then it's time to take action. Our teen participants decide what issues they wish to address, and we help them create an effective plan to speak out.
Who's ready to roll up their sleeves and get busy in our community? Who's ready to show the world what young people can do when they come together and they use their voice? Who's ready? By show of hands, I want to know who's ready. Okay, so now it's action time.
And I really want you all to focus on what's your squeaky wheel issue, right? Yeah. Like what is the issue that matters to you that you feel like you need to organize around? And we want to help you make that happen. By the end of this, really make sure that those people who are in positions of power know what your feelings are on those issues.
So we're not just talking, we're about to put it into action. So tell us what concerns you. You're at your table, start speaking amongst your table, talk about what's going on, what's happening in Harlem, what needs to be changed, what do you want to see fixed, what do you need to see happen?
Well, my name is Nakai Santiago. I'm a senior at Eagle Academy. That's what I'm representing. So for our passion, we mainly focused on Black liberation and how we liberate ourselves mentally. So we all put a little bit of points that we made to do that. So first was creating spaces to free our minds. So I know that a lot of us in the room, we all relate to a lot of things that we probably don't know about, but we all live in inner city, we all hear the gunshots at night, and we all watch our parents struggle sometimes. So that's burdens that we carry. that we could probably create spaces where we could let that out and give each other the advice to one another.
See, most people now in the schools, they bring each other down when they should bring each other up. Like, help them succeed and not fail.
One of the things that we can do as students to prevent this is we can make emotional assessments to support groups in our school, which can make students feel comfortable instead of saying things that we can't say in front of our mother, like things like suicide and depression, that we don't want our mother to like care for us as much as that.
I'm a king and I'm chasing greatness.
I'm a king and I'm chasing greatness.
If I can't control myself,
if I can't control myself.